Hello everybody and welcome back to Jack Wall Plays Euro Truck Simulator 2. I had to think for a minute there. We're going to go straight into the job market and see what jobs are available. Now I'm very price orientated at the moment because I want to earn as much money as possible. And I can do a job for 2,422 from Vienna to Linz. And I get to drive a Volvo F16 sleeper. This looks like possibly quite a nice truck. So it's the best paying job. So we'll take it. It's not that far to go, it looks like. Linz should be about, I would say, 2.5 hours, maybe 3 hours. Right, so we're... Wow. Oh, God, it's a bit noisy out there. Okay. So this is the Volvo. It's a sleeper, and let's pop outside and have a look. So that's what she looks like outside. It's quite nice. And I've got a couple of containers to load on, and yeah. There we go. Okay. God, those farm noises are interesting, so, well, shall we move her on out? Ooh, this sounds a lot different. Oh, I'm liking this. I'm liking the sound of this. Wow, okay. Wow, so the sounds are not all the same, at least the first truck, which was the Mercedes truck, and I think it was a very straightforward Mercedes. It wasn't anything fancy about it. It was fine. This one sounds a bit nicer. And it's got the retarder on there. So I'm going to have to come to a stop here as this procession of cars gets pulled through. And we have a new mail, which is fantastic. I'm liking that. Now what the hell is going on here? This orange car has decided to stop. Lorry is going through. Oh, I'm getting flashed. Alright. Well, I'm clear over there, but I'm not sure what's going on here. I'm blocking the road now. Alright, what the hell? So, okay. I think they've overdone the I'm a stupid car driver modeling program bit. I'm gonna have to back up here. I've got no damage to my truck, but no complete... What happened? Ah, man. That wasn't the intention to have a crash that early. The idiot just drove into me. Well, it's an AI and it's badly programmed, I suppose, but, you know. This is... Okay, is this car gonna just drive into me? No, he's not yet going to drive into me. He may drive into me later. Definitely decided that I'm going to drive out here. I can go now. Okay. We're good. Well, that was an interesting experience. I was flashed. Okay. Learning here. I'm treating the AI like they have some sense of intelligence, which is a stupid thing to do. So my bad. That said, he was stopped. He had, I believed, flashed me to let me out, and I am aware that in the game that is that is a function of the AI. They have that function. They will flash you and let you out. Sometimes, apparently, quite annoyingly from looking at some videos. But once you proceed into the road and are waiting to merge into the traffic, they're not. Well, I guess I wasn't expecting that he was just going to go and drive into my steering wheel, or my front driver's wheel. So. Bravo, well done. The good news is there's no damage. So that really is good news, because if there's damage, then it's costing. So happy about that, but what do you do with that? Okay, well, just need to be more careful of the AI going forward. And basically don't assume anything apart from the worst. Today I was driving into work. It's a two-lane, it's a small highway, it's two lanes. And there are some roadworks for a couple of kilometers in the middle. So there's a speed restriction to 80 kilometers there, after which then everybody can go back to the national limit, which is 130 kilometers an hour. And as you can imagine, you know, there's pent-up energy and frustration because people are late in the morning. And they're stuck at 80. I'm doing closer to 90, actually, in the zone. I'm going along with the flow of traffic, but I'm a little over 80 on my mark. And I have a guy that's right up my tailpipe as ever. So yeah, I got no problem with these kind of people, because you know he's not going to pay my ticket when I get pulled over for speeding. I'm not going to drive on the 80 mark either. Legally I should, and I'm wrong to say I'm going to do a little bit over, but I'm running, you know, I'm running 83 or 84, maybe 85. It's in the mark, and he's up my tailpipe the whole way. This is a regular thing. This is not just this morning. This is star par for the course. This is standard. So anyway, we get to the exit at the other side. Now I have no interest in blocking the guy any more than I need to, and I pull over to release him, to let him off. But he decides that you know, he doesn't really want to pass me, and so he stays right behind me. Now he's not right up my tailpipe anymore, because I've speeded up now, or I've sped up, whatever the English is, to you know, I'm pushing 130 now, maybe even pushing 131. So he's a decent distance behind me, but he's not making any effort to pass. And so I kind of keep an eye on him for a couple of minutes, and we separate a little bit more, and I forget about him. So carry on 2 or 3 minutes later down the lane, and I'm still in this lane, actually. I'm in this lane. It's a two-lane highway, not a three one, but I'm in the, whatever this is called, the inside lane. And I'm coming up on a slower moving car. I'm gaining on them slowly. And there's also an exit coming up. But in the outside lane, there's a car gaining on me quite slowly. And right behind that car, guess who? We have Mr. Silver Volvo. He was driving a Volvo. Mr. Silver Volvo is right up your man's tailpipe. So I'm kind of, you know, not really too bothered about it. I've noticed that I'm keeping an eye on it, and I'm closing in on this guy in front of me, and we're all closing in on this exit off that section of the motorway. So I've backed up a little bit, because you know, I don't have anywhere to go anyway, and I don't have enough room to pull out in front of this car that's creeping up on me slowly. And so I back up a little bit, and the car, it was a blue car, I don't recall it, the blue car came in, and because I've backed up and there's enough space now, he's come in, he's pulled into the inside lane in front of me, again to release Mr. Volvo. And guess what? Mr. Volvo decides to follow him in, and now there's no room for Mr. Volvo to follow him in. But he follows him in, hitting the brakes as he's slowing down. I mean, this is, I'm on the brakes fairly heavy. There's nothing behind me immediately, but it's, you know, it's fairly heavy braking. And he goes, Mr. Volvo then decides to take the exit and starts to indicate when he's about halfway into the exit, like as if it's really necessary to ask him where he's going at that stage. I tell you, it's, what do you do? What do you do with these people? So that was a drive-in in the morning, and the reason I'm saying that is, you know, the AI might be modeled to be pretty dumb, and certainly that particular AI incident struck me as being rather stupid. But there's a good chance that it's actually reflecting from a lorry driver's perspective, you know, everyday driving experiences on the road for these guys. And SES software may be forgiven for perhaps taking it to a stage, to a standard that might be slightly higher than it ought be, but hey, it is what it is. They manage it. Now, I have noticed that I've gone wrong, and perhaps you've noticed before me, which is not good. I should have been following my GPS, but instead I was telling you this really highly exciting story of my drive-in this morning. So I've taken this exit, and I'm hoping that it'll link me somehow back to where it is I need to go. So I've, oh god, jeez, I'm driving well away from Lens, and there's no real hope of turning around. Ah. That is a little bit of a problem. Okay, okay. So we do need to turn around up here, and we're not going to have an opportunity to do that for a little while, it seems. Bastard. Ah, shit. Well, anyway, okay, we get to drive further than intended. How are we doing on fuel? We're good. Driving hours, we are good. Distance, we're way off. Oh, delivery. When do I need to have it delivered? I got 4 hours to get back to Linz. I should be able to do that. I should be able to find a place to turn over. I have noticed that my steering is very, very, very sensitive. I might need to knock that down. Aha! Now, there may be an opportunity to do a turnaround here. There is as well. I shall pull in here. I think I'm going to break a couple of laws. This is what you should not do. For the purpose of explanation, let's see if I can get away with doing it. We've already had one crash, so, like, what's the worst that can happen? I get a fine for going the wrong way. And I am clear on the other side. So, ooh, I think I got away with that. Did too. So no police officers were there and all the cameras were turned off, and actually nobody saw it. So apart from you and me, nobody knows that I kind of did a very, very illegal maneuver, which would probably not have worked anyway in the real world. It would have drawn the attention of somebody and probably would have resulted in a significant reprimand. I mightn't be driving anymore for a while, possibly even. But I got away with it. Sometimes in life, you hope you can get away with it. Sometimes, it's never really justified, but sometimes to hell with it, you just have a go anyway. Anyway, back to this Volvo. I do quite like this Volvo. Now, it's FH16, whatever that means. Honestly, I don't know. It's... Yeah, it's not bad up there. It's got its radio up there, keeping the road jiggy. Inside it's looking fairly okay. Nothing fancy, but that's better. You can now see the whole deal. Looks fairly clean in there. Mirrors are pretty good on both sides. I haven't adjusted the mirrors at all. They're pretty much as you see. If I was driving this truck for real, I think I might open out the mirrors a little bit to only get a little bit of my cab and just enough of my trailer that I can see it in the mirrors and get a little bit more of the road onto the left side of the mirror. I do need to sort out the sensitivity on the steering is a little too high though, so we'll fix that when we finish this delivery. So that's my foot braking, which is not bad. I'm not using the retarder here. I'm just gently easing her back. And now you hear she's pulling and you can hear that little whistle of the turbo and the muffler giving plenty of background noise. I quite like that sound in here. Scenery is pretty awesome for a game function. It's not photorealistic, but it's quite enjoyable to look at. Quite impressed with that, I must say. Skies look quite interesting as well. A bit painted up there, as they seem, but you know, everything's relative. I'm quite impressed with the whole road structures and you know, the detail that's on here, the signs and the edge markers. And, yeah. It's quite a pretty game, it's pretty. I do need to go down here. So we'll give ourselves a bit of a heavy braking session. And, I'm not going to just drive out there blatantly and then go to brake too much. Oh, my retarder was on still. Okay. That's okay. So we're going to go up onto this other motorway though, or not. Where the hell are we going? Oh, we're going towards Salzburg, which would be right. Which time do we have left? 21 minutes. Sorry dear. 21 minutes. 20 minutes and 20 kilometers. Coming into the outskirts of Linz now, based on our quick check of the map earlier. And now we're going over the motorway. Ooh. Moments lapse there. That's... I'll blame the steering, but you know that's me. That was all me. But the steering is a little too sensitive as well, which was actually helpful because it meant that I could correct more quickly, but it also was partly responsible for causing the issue in the first place. Maybe I need to put in just a little bit of dead zone. Just a little weeny teeny squeeny little bit. Alright, so we come sailing in here at a nice old rate of knots. We've discovered a recruiting agency where we can hire drivers who will work for you. Yeah, we'll need that when we buy our garage or set up our garage and hire some workers when we have enough money to buy some trucks for them. But until then, we're going to be driving for hire in whatever truck is going wherever with whatever load. The only criteria that I'll be really focused on is how much money am I getting paid to do this run. I'm going for the money. I'm into post speed, which is here. I'm going for the money. I'm going to build up my money as quickly as possible, whilst experiencing as much as I can of the various trucks and routes and destinations and pickup points and all of that. But mostly the trucks. so that I can make a decision on what kind of truck I'm going to start my career and buy. God, now we have to do some parking again. You remember the last parking effort? It was not good. So let's head out the window for this again. Kinda crooked, but we're good. So, we're delivered. A nice little climb of points, and we've gone up to newbie level, so that's good. That's good. So now we get to spend a skill point. Ooh. Now, you can go through all of this in your own time. I'm not going to read it all out, but my logic generally is I'm going to start with the long distance. I'm going to do that right now. And I'm going to build up most of the long distance before I start filling in the high value next, and then following that, the fragile. But I'm basically going to fill this, then fill this, and then fill this. After that, I'm going to start sharing my skill points with the remaining three categories. That's my strategy. So anyway, there we go. We do have a mail, so let's have a look and see. One unread message. Brand new majestic truck for sale. Okay. They're a certified dealer, and this is just an advertisement meaning come and spend some money with us in Stuttgart. Okay. Not yet, pal, because we don't have any money. How much money do we have? We have 4,725. Well, it's not bad. I did say I was going to check the sensitivity here, so got to bring that down fairly significantly. Non-linearity. I don't remember. Non-linearity. This is linearity, so I'll leave that alone. And one other thing that I wanted to do, I think, was I was going to do something with the dead zone, wasn't I? If I could find it. Steering dead zone. I was going to give myself just a little bit. Not a lot. But, yeah, that's too much. There, that's not bad. Take a little bit more off, and yeah, that's better. Okay, I'm gonna save that. Okay, well, that concludes this second episode. So take it handy, and catch you later.